Byron Coley.
Yeah.
A couple of variations on A Visit from St. Nicholas, which admittedly is a, you know, Christmas Eve ballad, but what the hell? We're very close to Christmas Eve. The first is A Visit from St. Nicholas in the Ernest Hemingway manner, written by James Thurber for the 1927 Christmas edition of The New Yorker. It was the night before Christmas. The house was very quiet. No creatures were stirring in the house. There weren't even any mice stirring. The stockings had been hung carefully by the chimney. The children hoped that St. Nicholas would come and fill them. The children were in their beds. Their beds were in the room next to ours. Mama and I were in our beds. Mama wore a kerchief. I had my cap on. I could hear the children moving. We didn't move. We wanted the children to think we were asleep. Father, the children said. There was no answer. He's there, all right, they thought. Father, they said, and banged on their beds. What do you want? I asked. We have visions of sugar plums, the children said. Go to sleep, said Mama. We can't sleep, said the children. They stopped talking, but I could hear them moving. They made sounds. Can you sleep? Asked the children. No, I said. You ought to sleep. I know I ought to sleep. Can we have some sugar plums? You can't have any sugar plums, said Mama. We just asked you. There was a long silence. I could hear the children moving again. Is St. Nicholas asleep? Asked the children. No, Mama said. Be quiet. What the hell would he be asleep tonight for? I asked. He might be, the children said. He isn't, I said. Let's try to sleep, said Mama. The house became quiet once more. I could hear the rustling noises the children made when they moved in their beds. Out on the lawn, a clatter arose. I got out of the bed and went to the window. I opened the shutters, then I threw up the sash. The moon shone on the snow. The move gave the luster of midday to the objects in the snow. There was a miniature sleigh in the window and eight tiny reindeer. A little man was driving them. He was lively and quick. He whistled and shouted at the reindeer and called them by their names. Their names were Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donder, and Blitzen. He told them to dash away to the top of the porch, and then he told them to dash away to the top of the wall. They did. The sleigh was full of toys. Who is it? Mama asked. Some guy, I said, a little guy. I pulled my head in out of the window and listened. I heard reindeer on the roof. I could hear their hoofs pawing and prancing on the roof. Shut the window, said Mama. I stood still and listened. What do you hear? Reindeer, I said. I shut the window and walked about. It was cold. Mama sat up in bed and looked at me. How would they get on the roof? Mama asked. They fly. Get into bed, you'll catch cold. Mama lay down in the bed. I didn't get into the bed. I kept walking around. What do you mean they fly? Asked Mama. Just fly is all. Mama turned away toward the wall. She didn't say anything. I went out into the room where the chimney was. The little man came down the chimney and stepped into the room. He was dressed all in fur. His clothes were covered with ashes and soot from the chimney. On his back was a pack, like a peddler's pack. There were toys in it. His cheeks and nose were red, and he had dimples. His eyes twinkled. His mouth was little, like a bow, and his beard was very white. Between his teeth was a stumpy pipe. The smoke from the pipe encircled his head in a wreath. He laughed and his belly shook. It shook like a bowl of red jelly. I laughed. He winked his eye, then gave a twist to his head. He didn't say anything. He turned to the chimney and filled the stockings and turned away from the chimney. laying a finger aside his nose, he gave a nod, and then he went up the chimney. I went to the chimney and looked up. I saw him get into his sleigh. He whistled his team, and the team flew away. The team flew as lightly as thistledown. The driver called out, "Merry Christmas and good night." I went back to bed. "What was it?" asked Mama. "St. Nicholas?" She smiled. "Yeah," I said. She sighed and turned in the bed. "I saw him," I said. "Sure." "I did see him." "Sure you saw him." She turned farther toward the wall. "Father," said the children. "There you go," Mama said. "You and your flying reindeer." "Go to sleep," I said. "Can we see St. Nicholas when he comes?" the children asked. "You got to be asleep," I said. "You got to be asleep when he comes. You can't see him unless you're unconscious." "Father knows," Mama said. I pulled the covers over my mouth. It was warm under the covers. As I went to sleep, I wondered if Mama was right. That was a request by Aaron Rosenblum. The second... Recorded by Ed Burns of the television show Route 66. I think it was around 61 he did this. I can't really remember. I should have looked it up. It's called Yulesville. "'Twas the night before Christmas and all through the pad, not a hip cat was swinging, and that's nowhere, Dad. The stove was hung up in that stocking routine, like maybe the fat man would soon make the scene. The kids had fell by and just made the street. I was ready for Snoresville. Man, I was beat. When there started a rumble, it came on real frantic. So I opened the window to figure the panic. I saw a slick rod that was making fat tracks, souped up by 8 ponies all wearing hat racks. And a funny old geezer was flipping his lid. He told them to make it, and man, like they did. They were out of the chute making time like a bat, turning quarter in 8 seconds flat. Parked by the smokestack in bunches and clusters, then Chubby slid down, coming up like gangbusters. His threads were from Cubesville, and I had to chuckle. In front, not in back, was this Ivy League buckle. The mop on his chin hit a button-down collar, and with that red nose, Dan, he looked like a baller. Like he was the squarest, the most absolute, but let's face it, huh? Who cares when he left all that loot? He laid the jazz on me and peeled from the gig, wheeling, "Have a cool Yule, man," and later, like, dig. That's it.
Woo! What was your name? Hey!
Enter the world of Maine with IDM Theftable. Sir? Scott? To you.
What was that?
Sorry.
No need to apologize. Hello. One moment. There's something burning, and we're smelling it together. There's something burning, and we're smelling it together. Give the finger to the dark night outside your window. Just in case, give a finger to the dark night outside your window. Just in case, give the finger to the dark night outside the window. Just in case. There's something burning, and we're smelling it together. From the gas station, the full height of my finger, extended. Oh, the full height of my finger, extended. Smells like gas, the shit piling high on the floor. There's something burning, and we're smelling it together. There's something burning, and we're smelling it together. Thank you. bit of nuggets. something burning and we're smelling it together. Gas station, parking lot. Abandoned spider webs. Melt. Masks on the ground. Bon Jovi, Aerosmith, wet, melt, spill, hold, holding, staring at a phone. Blood pool on alone. Blood in the melt. Green paint in the melt. A spit of milk. It's a folding chair. Masks on the ground. Pools of dog piss. cool stuff. Dog piss.
Burning. Thanks, you guys. Thank you guys. That was
amazing.
Oh. Well, beautiful, everyone.
Wow.
Yeah.
The best. What do we do now?
Tip the artist.
Tip the artist. I'll leave info.
Tip me over.